Tim, what would be your suggestion for a dress watch on the more formal side, under $15,000, that isn't one of the usual suspects? Okay, it's not one of the usual suspects. And a diver to survive the Houston storm we have going on here. I would say a great suggestion if you're willing to deal with a more traditionally proportioned watch, but epically beautiful, would be an early Lange Saxonia from the 90s. You can't miss. Finish, wrist presence, brand pedigree, and you can get them well under $15,000. And a diver, he's also asking for a diver to survive the epic Houston storm we're having here. All the best, man. Hang in there. I would say, honestly, my favorite diver from off the beaten path is the Carl F. Bucherer Petravi Scuba Tech. You get a lot of watch for your money. A great watch, a great bracelet, a great clasp. In the hand, it feels as substantial as a Rolex, and I can't say that of many watches out there. What do you guys think? Sub $15,000 dress watch and a diver, but not from the usual suspects. You can go like Zenith if you want. If you want, you can say IWC Portofino. Anything's fair game.
I have a newfound love for Glashutte. Not a usual suspect, but still high up in recognition for like well-made German watches, not Swiss watches. But yeah, I think they're beautifully designed. I think they're well-made watches, and you can get them for below 15.
Yeah, something like the Senator 60s.
Absolutely.
Really nice collection.
Yeah, and I know you said off the beaten path, but for some reason my mind just keeps going back to JLC. Obviously, a huge amount of watches that you could buy, some simple, some complicated, but for some reason my mind keeps going there when you say dress watch.
I'll be honest with you, if you can deal with 34 millimeters, the best watch I ever bought for the money was my 34 millimeter Master Ultra Thin, a movement like you will not see in the sub $10,000 price range, and it's the same Bausch developed for Audemars and Vacheron during the 1950s. Display case back, 6 millimeters thick, epically beautiful, wears well with anything but a bathing suit. And remember this. It's true. I've worn it with everything but a bathing suit. You could probably swing that Master Ultra Thin Perpetual pre-owned for $15,000. Something to think about. All right. So, oh boy, the JLC drinking game. If you guys aren't familiar with this, there's a JLC drinking game going. I'm sorry, I probably just lost the factory's endorsement forever and all time. But apparently every time I mention JLC during these broadcasts, people are taking shots. Guys, I hope it's spring water, because you're going to be gone.
I think we should join that. I think we should do that with our audience and see how it goes.
You know what? I have a bottle of Knob Creek somewhere around here. Next time. The holidays are coming, guys. All right. So let me just double check right here. But Bob F. asks, hi, Tim. It seems like the price of a Swiss Tourbillon watch is falling, with Ulysse Nordin asking $28,000 for theirs and Tag Heuer launching a $15,000 Tourbillon. On the face of it, let me just explain. It does look like the price is falling. People are wondering, these used to be $100,000 watches, and now you're seeing watches for a quarter or a sixth of that price, and you're wondering, what gives? What has changed? Is this the same kind of watch at a lower price, or has something been cut out of the equation? And that's where I kind of want to bring my watch in as a demonstrator. I'm hauling my Reverso Platinum number 2 up onto the table to demonstrate. There's no secret here, guys. Ulysse Nordin has managed to take in-house a lot of material, from movement construction to silicon technology to grand faux enameling and case manufacture, so they could get their price down to $28,000. But make no mistake, the movement of both watches, the UN and the Tag Heuer, has excellent mechanical finish, but not the kind of artisanal, you know, blood, sweat, and tears finish that you see on a Patek Philippe Tourbillon, that you see on this Platinum number 2, that you'll see on something from Audemars Piguet like a Royal Oak Tourbillon. These are all watches that are finished by hand, and you pay not so much for the escapement that spins. That's easy to do, and you can get it for under $1,000 in a Chinese watch. It's the degree of regulation to make it actually keep good time, and the finishing to make it beautiful and exclusive. And because of the human effort that goes into a watch like this, it can never cost $15,000. What you're getting from Tag is a very impressively made watch that's mostly machine built, but gives you a lot of value for your money. That's the distinction between a $100,000 tourbillon and a mostly machine-built, though human-assembled, $15,000 tourbillon. Zoe, have we seen any of these yet? Have we seen any of the tags come through?
Not yet. I think...
I sold a pre-owned a couple of months ago.
And do you mind if I ask what it sold for, pre-owned or roughly?
You know what? I actually don't remember off the top of my head. It came in from a big collector we had who bought it from the boutique, and then we sold it pre-owned. I don't actually remember. I'd have to take a look.
It's probably fair to say pre-owned Tag Heuer sells for like 65 cents on the dollar. 60 to 65
yeah.
cents. So you take your $15,000 watch, sells about 60 cents, 65 cents on the dollar second time around. Again, that sounds bad until you realize that the $100,000 artisanally finished tourbillon that I've gushed over, this watch was $126,000 in 2003 and I paid 30 for it in 2015. The Tag Heuer actually held its value percentage-wise a lot better than the artisanally finished tourbillon. A lot better. But that's how I'm able to own one, so I'm not complaining.